G'day, Chris here, and welcome back to Clickspring. With the main wheel complete, it's time to make the barrel assembly. So in this episode, I'll use the length of this tubing and these offcuts to make this. This is how the barrel fits into the clock design. It mounts directly onto the large wheel and the whole assembly rotates around the barrel arbor. So I need to make two end caps, as well as the barrel wall, which has a recess at each end to accept the caps. The rear cap bushing must be a slip fit for the wheel, but the front cap bushing doesn't have to fit anything, it just has to look good, so let's give it a nice rounded edge. So let's get started. I think it's much easier to turn the caps to fit the barrel wall rather than the other way around, so I'll make the barrel wall first. First up, it's a trip to the bandsaw to cut off a section of that tubing. The tubing is mounted on the lathe chuck with the jaws lightly gripping from the inside and the stock sitting clear of the back of the chuck jaws. And then it's given a little bump with the centering tool to set it true. Once it's running true on the chuck, the jaws can be tightened. The rough edge was then tidied up with a facing cut. And you can see from the long stringy chips, this is not a free machining brass, but rather a lead free variety. It's not my favourite brass to machine, but with the right speeds and feeds, it does give a good result. Both the inside and outside were given a skim cut to true up the surfaces, and then I machined the recess for the rear cap, taking quite light cuts to get a good finish. This section was then parted off, a little over length, to allow for machining of the other end. It was then remounted on the chuck, this time pressed up against the back of the chuck jaws. A quick check shows it's running fairly true. Now the part needs to be faced to final length and to then have the front recess machined. So I completed the facing cut and then machined the second recess with a slight back taper by feeding in with the compound on a 3-degree angle. The barrel cap will be made with a rounded edge, so this taper will give it a nice snap fit in the barrel. That's the machining for the barrel wall complete. Now for the barrel caps. I started by cutting out two oversized blanks from these offcuts. Now these caps will need machining on both the edges and the front surface before we're done, so it's a perfect job for a superglue arbor. If you're wondering what the grooves are for, it's to make sure that the glue has enough air to fully cure. Without the grooves, the perimeter seals off the glue in the middle and it stays liquid. The first machining step for the caps is to knock off the rough edges of the blank and turn down the diameter, leaving it a little oversized for now. The centre hole was then drilled, slightly undersized. I plan to manually broach out these cap holes later, using a clockmaker's cutting broach. That way the holes will fit the barrel arbor precisely. I'll give you some more detail on this in the next video of this series, when I make the barrel arbor. Now superglue arbors work very well, but they're not without limits, and I did push my luck a bit here with the depth of cut. You can see the part get the wobbles about now. I generated quite a bit of heat, the heat softens the glue until it fails. I refixed it to the arbor, gave it a quick cut to true up the ball, and we're back in business. Now that the part is in basic shape, the bushing is reduced to be a slip fit for the main wheel bore, with a good undercut to give the wheel a clear seating on the cap. So with a good fit with the wheel confirmed, I faced the flange to final width and then gave the front of the bushing a little whisper cut as well. And before moving on, I made another quick check that the wheel seating was still good after that last facing cut. The perimeter of the cap was then reduced to exact diameter to give it a nice slip fit for the back of the barrel. And that's the rear cap complete. A bit of heat breaks the superglue bond. And that rear cap can now be permanently fixed into place in the barrel. I'm going to bond it with Loctite, so the parts need a good clean with lighter fluid before applying the glue. The inside of the barrel recess needs to be cleaned too to get a good seating for the cap. After a few minutes, the excess glue was wiped off and the part set aside to cure. The front cap was machined to begin with in a similar fashion. And I bored the centre hole on this one too, just to be consistent with that rear cap. However, the difference with this cap is that when close to diameter, the perimeter was brought to final dimension with files, and it was given a radiused edge. As I mentioned earlier, the objective is to get a good snap fit with the tapered recess in the barrel. The last operation on the lathe was to use these gravers to turn the radiused edge on the front bushing. And that's the front cap done. Now the cap fit is okay, but it does have a slight amount of play in it, more than I'd like. The solution is to lightly hammer the perimeter to expand it a small amount. And after doing this, the fit is much improved. This cap also needs a little prising slot cut into it, so it can be levered off the barrel when the clock is serviced. And that's the barrel done for now. In the next episode, I'll make the barrel arbor and broach out the barrel cap holes. Thanks for watching. I'll see you later. If you've enjoyed this video, here's a few more I think you might like. I post regular home machine shop project videos like these, so be sure to subscribe. And have a look at the Clickspring Projects website too for more tool making info. Thanks again for watching. I'll catch you on the next video.